All of the voices that you will hear in this video are artificially generated. A link to the original video, narrated by a human, can be found in the description below.
For information about the voices used in this video, there is a link below in the description. If you want to show your support for this channel, you can buy us a coffee. The link is also in the description. Thank you. Today, I'm going to tell you everything I know about metal screw-in lens hoods. As you can imagine, there's not that much to know. But, hopefully it will give some insight. These are three seemingly very similar 67mm lens hoods, but there is one subtle difference that separates these hoods. The threads are the same, there is a slight difference in weight between them, but the keen-eyed amongst you will have already noticed that the main difference is the amount of internal light reflection. These internal reflections get progressively less as we look at them from left to right, more on that in a minute. For those of you not familiar with this type of hood, they are available with different thread sizes, different tube lengths, and different shapes. This one is good for wide-angle lenses. The thread on these hoods is fairly standard, and the corresponding size will fit any lens which has a thread for a filter. You will of course have to choose the correct hood size and shape to prevent vignetting. There is usually a thread on the other end of the hood, which is normally larger in size than the base thread. Again, this is a standard thread in which you can screw a filter, or perhaps another lens hood. Now, let's talk about internal reflection. The whole reason for using a hood is to prevent stray light from entering the lens, so the less reflection inside the hood, the better. This is what separates these hoods. Here is a quick test. Let me introduce some sunshine. The first hood has a fairly large hotspot when hit by a strong light. The second hood shows a definite improvement. But, finally, the Ciotti lens hood with its anti-glare oxidation treatment actually eliminates the hotspot altogether. Impressive! So, what else do you get when you buy a Ciotti lens hood? It's applied with a lens cap of the correct size to fit the end of the lens hood. In some situations, the lens cap is unable to make contact with the front lens element should it become loose in your camera bag. This eliminates any concern that the cap is grinding away at the front of the lens. They also supply what appears to be a microfiber lens cloth, which I have tried and is actually quite decent. I bought mine directly from the website, as I have had issues with receiving non-genuine parts from other sources. I won't mention any names. The site is at ciotti.co, where there is a great selection of sizes and shapes. The prices are reasonable, and they are delivered for free. I have so far received my orders within 10 days, so not too bad. I use this particular Ciotti lens hood with my Olympus 40-150 Pro. The actual thread is 72mm, but I first use a reducer and then the 67mm hood. I prefer to keep the hood at the same width as the lens, and there is no vignetting. I leave this hood on permanently, it protects the lens, and for me, eliminates the need for a protective filter of any kind. The other bonus is that the original 72mm lens cap still fits. One word of warning. Do not over-tighten these threads. You will regret it. Tighten them just enough to grip as required. You can also use the hoods with filters, as most of them come with a thread for purposes such as this. This 62mm variable ND filter has a 67mm external thread. As you can see, using a hood with variable NDs or polarizers, it's easier to turn the filters to the desired position. I hope that you found this useful. You now know as much as me about these metal screw-in lens hoods. Cheers for now, and take good care.
The music, Giving Me Hope, was brought to you by Irvi Goldfinger.
If you like the voices that you have heard in this video, please click the link below, and for very little cost, we can narrate your next project.
Please guys, hit the like button and subscribe. Thanks.